Hello friends, welcome to this video on circles. In the previous video, we learned about perpendicular from the center to a chord. Today, we will solve some questions related to the same. Come on, let's start. In the given figure, line segment OE of length 3 cm bisects chord AB of length 8 cm. Point F is on the circle such that OE plus EF is equal to OF. Now, find the radius of the circle and length of EF. Let's solve this. Friends, we are given that line segment OE bisects the chord AB. And in the figure, you can see that point O is the center of the circle. So line segment OE will be perpendicular to chord AB. Because a line drawn through the center of the circle to bisect a chord is perpendicular to the chord. Therefore, angle OEA and angle OEB will be 90 degrees. So, how do we proceed now? Friends, if we join O with point A and point B, then we get the radii of the circle OA and OB and the two right angle triangles OEA and OEB. Friends, you can see that OA and OB are the hypotenuse of the right angle triangles OEA and OEB respectively. Friends, we are given the length of AB as 8 cm. E is its midpoint, that is, AE and BE are equal. Therefore, their length will be 4 cm. Now, by using the Pythagoras theorem in either of the two triangles, we can find the radius of the circle. Using the Pythagoras theorem in triangle OEB, we can write it in this way. We know the lengths of OE and BE. On simplifying it, we get the length of OB as 5 cm. In this way, we found the radius of the circle. Friends, let's move ahead. We have to find the length of EF. Given that point F is on the circle, such that we join OE and EF, OF is obtained. We know that a line segment from the center of the circle to any point on the circle is the radius of that circle. Hence, OF is the radius of this circle. That is, it will also be 5 cm. We know the length of OE. By putting the value of OE and OF, we can find the value of EF. In this way, we found EF to be 2 cm. Let's move ahead and solve our next question. A circle with radius 6 cm and center O has a perpendicular OD drawn on chord PQ, where the length of OD is 2 cm. Now, find the area of triangle ODQ and triangle OPQ. You can also pause the video and try it yourself. Friends, the radius of the circle is given to be 6 cm. And we know that by joining any line segment from the center of the circle to any point on the circle gives the radius of the circle. So, OP and OQ are the radii of the circle. Therefore, the length of OP and OQ will be 6 cm. We have to find the area of triangle ODQ here. Friends, we know that the formula for the area of a triangle is half multiplied by base multiplied by height. Therefore, we can write the area of triangle ODQ as follows. Let's consider this as equation 1. According to the question, line segment OD is perpendicular to chord PQ. Therefore, triangle ODQ will be a right angle triangle. And OD is the height of this triangle, which is given to be 2 cm. Friends, we know the height of the triangle ODQ. But we have to find the value of the base DQ. We can use the Pythagoras theorem in this triangle and find the length of DQ. Friends, pause the video and try to find it yourself. Here, we get the length of DQ as 4 square root of 2 cm. Now, by placing the values of DQ and OD in equation 1, we can find the area of triangle ODQ. We get the area of triangle ODQ as 4 square root of 2 cm square. Now, we have to find the area of triangle OPQ. Friends, there are many ways to find this. Can you tell the length of PQ? Yes. We are given the line segment OD is perpendicular to chord PQ and O is the center of the circle. Friends, we know that a perpendicular drawn from the center of a circle to a chord bisects the chord. Therefore, PD is equal to DQ and we can write PQ like this. We found DQ as 4 square root of 2 cm. So here, chord PQ will be 8 square root of 2 cm. Friends, now find the area of triangle OPQ yourself. Here's a hint. Friends, that's all in this session. Today, we solved some questions related to a perpendicular from the center to a chord. See you in the next video. Thank you.